far, sometimes till the show, but good to see the mate there winning the crowd's favour. Absolutely. What have we got coming next? Looks to me like the Tucano's coming next.
That's right, Tucano's from Royal Air Force Leeds and Honorius. This is Royal Air Force's basic flying trainer. All those aircraft today are piloted by qualified flying instructors.
It's spelling out 60 in the sky, that's no surprise.
It is. This is a formation that they've been practicing in honor of Her Majesty's Diamond Jubilee.
She looked thrilled. That's very impressive indeed. And of course, we're getting a sense really of the progression, I suppose. We're getting the Carnos in first, which are used as trainers. Then we're getting something a bit more spicy, which they've gone to after their initial training.
Yes, that's correct. There are a couple of elements between these and the former trainers, which we'll be following later on.
C-130s, huge transport aircraft. These are unmistakable in outline. And these, of course, are incredibly busy at the moment, aren't they?
Absolutely. They are moving troops all over the world and freight all over the world. We very rarely see a C-130 back in the UK, to be honest. They're so busy.
And when people talk about deploying abroad to Libya, Afghanistan, it's the C-130s, the forgotten heroes, the crew who fly them, carrying all that material, all those people and supplies, all the way around the world.
This is true, and obviously absolutely vital to the support of the troops on the ground and operations worldwide by dropping freight to them and supplies to them when they need them.
Excited now, Simon. I don't know why, because you circle around the world, you circle in Kosovo, Afghanistan, and often your favourite aircraft, surely, Tornadoes. Here we've got two Tornadoes accompanying a VC-10, and it's got its refuelling hoses out, demonstrating it's actually a refuelling aircraft. What are those Tornadoes like to fly?
Oh, they're absolutely incredible machines, to be honest. Again, another aircraft that delivers protection to the troops on the ground overseas, and it really is a magnificent machine.
Of course, those Tornadoes we saw are the bombing version, so they carry out strikes, they carry weapons like Brimstone and Storm Shadow to attack targets on the ground.
Yeah, and let's not forget as well that a good proportion of its duties out in Afghanistan is reconnaissance as well for counter roadside bomb work.
Of course, a lot of these aircraft, including the helicopters, are used at the moment to spot IEDs, aren't they? Very important role.
They are, and that is very, very important to help protect the troops on the ground.
Right, the Hawks, these are the guys I was working with up in... What are they, is that ER?
That is indeed an E2R.
That's extraordinary, E2R. That's what they were practicing up at Valley when I was there. That's incredible, they pulled it off perfectly.
Absolutely, and as I say, the formation skills here are just a repeat, really, of what is a basic pilot skill throughout the Royal Air Force. And let's not forget, there are also three Hawks from the Royal Navy involved in that formation as well.
Majesty is absolutely thrilled with that. That is something that not all of us can expect in our lives. Now, what have we got here? This is the Red Arrows, the people's favourite. Here we are.
Yes, the Red Arrows, and this is a special Diamond Jubilee formation that they're flying today, a three-dimensional diamond line in honour of Her Majesty's Diamond Jubilee.
So this diamond formation we're seeing, of course, famously the smoke coming out of the back where diesel mixes with coloured dye. That's not just for a pretty decoration. Here it is now. It's actually very important in terms of their formation, isn't it?
That's true, yes. All the pilots are honestly very, very highly trained and very good at the formation flying, and the smoke is one of their references.
There go the Red Arrows. Recognisable around the world. The crowd are roaring. They've carried out thousands of displays in countries on every continent. No flypast is complete without them.
Absolutely.
Well, Simon, the weather held off for us. In fact, we got everything we wanted. The E2R was the highlight, possibly.
Yeah, well, we're absolutely delighted that we managed to get a full flypast in Her Majesty.